Well, having a bad hair day is inevitable for many of us, but if you are a royal, you simply can't afford one. The latest royal wedding saw luscious locks aplenty, and the man who styled Pippa Middleton and her party joins us now. Welcome to the show, UK celebrity hairstylist Daniel Galvin. Welcome back.
Thank you.
Now, since we last saw you, there have been some pretty big royal events. In fact, you did Pippa Middleton's wedding.
No,
her hen's party.
We contributed, yeah. We did a hen party with her, 20 of her friends, absolutely lovely girls. Of course, we pride ourselves on client confidentiality, so to keep that out of the press was quite a challenge,
yes.
But we managed to do so.
What can you give us, though? Can you tell us what they wanted everything. With their hair?
Oh, they had some voluminous hair. They're off to a private party. So they had braiding done, updos done. You know, we had all our stylists there. You know, the full Monty, doing what they do.
They love a blowout, don't they, the Middleton sisters?
Yes. Mm. They've got lovely hair and they're beautiful girls and absolutely charming as well.
And who else was at the hen's night?
Oh, I couldn't possibly say.
What is the trend with hair at the moment? What are celebrities wanting to do with their hair?
Well, it's quite diverse, really. I mean, what's on trend at the moment, the colour that I like being hair colourist, which is my heritage, is I love the rose gold, and that would suit you very much.
Rose gold?
So what do we think about rose gold, everyone?
Something tells me Jess would like to get a rose gold hairdo.
Yes, because Daniel has very generously said he would do it for me.
Jess, and he happens so to have cheeky. Brought the colour in today.
Yeah.
I just so happens to have it in my bag.
I think I just heard the executive producer pass out.
Everyone's quite excited.
What's rose gold?
And then, of course, rose gold.
What sort of colour is it?
Rose gold, it's similar
sort of,
to this
you know,
top, actually.
Soft. Pink.
What's wrong with what you've got already?
Don't. Now you sound like my husband.
Just leave it like it is. Don't change it. Remember when Kerry Bickmore went from blonde to brown?
Yeah, but that looked great.
No,
do you actually use...
Yes! And don't you think, I reckon what is so exciting about hair is it's the one thing you can change. You can have fun with it.
Yeah.
You can... It's wonderful.
Mm. Yeah, I mean, you know, hair colour is the ultimate cosmetic.
Yes.
So you should change it on a seasonal basis. You know, whether you're going lighter in the summer, brighter in the winter. And often at the end of the summer, you know, blondes particularly find themselves becoming a more uniform colour. Mm. So one of the other trends that we're seeing is something called bronder, where you're weaving the natural colour back through the mid-lengths of the hair to create more contrast and more movement. So it makes hair look thicker.
But is it damaging to be dyeing your hair so much throughout the
Ask
year?
Ask Joe.
Yeah, this takes a lot of work. Used to be a Clooney.
It really depends on what products you're using on your hair. And you should never really be putting the chemicals through the mid lengths and the ends every time. Doing them on the
body. Can you tell Jono that? Because his hair keeps changing.
He's sun-kissed.
Yeah. Daniel has done my hair. Be careful, please.
Really?
Back in London.
Have you actually done Jono's hair?
Long time ago.
Yeah, really?
What did he ask
what
for?
Was
he quite fussy?
Yeah.
Daniel, remember.
Well, some mothers do have them.
It's all about confidentiality. I went to a James Bond premiere with a young starlet who I was working with at the time, and he did a wonderful job of me. In fact, a lot of people mixed me up with the 007. I was like 008.
008.
Thank you, Daniel.
Can I ask, Daniel, who took longer, Jono or the starlet?
I can't quite remember. Sorry.
Is there a lot of... there's so much invested in someone like Pippa Middleton where the whole world is watching her every step at the hen's night, or whether you know there's going to be paparazzi or there's, you know, that whatever do you give her, a million people are going to be asking for the next day. Mm. How much pressure is there on you to get the do right, and how much fear is there if you get it wrong?
Well, as a colourist, and the boss, I'm there supervising my team, making sure they're doing a proper job on every single client, whether it's Mrs. Smith or... you know, a member of the royal family. Mm. But yes, there is a lot of pressure, and most of all, that sort of client confidentiality, keeping that away from the press and protecting them.
Mm. And you've got some great new products at the moment?
Yes, my organic head range, which is launched nationwide through Woolworths, an inspiring retailer. And this was a natural progression on the back of Double Trouble, which I was here talking about last time.
Because didn't Prince Charles actually, his people, talk to your people in order to get all this organic products underway? Oh.
Yes, well, we develop a lot of lotions and potions for His Royal Highness the Prince of Wales. And what we actually develop for out here is Double Trouble for kids. And we make a donation per unit sold to the Prince's Charities Australia, which helps local environmental and wildlife initiatives, also helping lock maybe kids from underprivileged or deprived backgrounds full potential. So it's amazing the difference and the vision that he has down under. And to be making a difference and to be here promoting that charity is a real privilege.
Oh, you can look good and feel good about doing it. Daniel Galvin, thank you so much.
Thank you very much.